Julian, head judge for tonight.
Yes.
You're looking understated as always.
Well, you know, Alan, I had to do my best. I'm out glitz and glamour at the occasion.
You look fabulous. You really do. Come here. I'm about to go in and talk to some of them tonight, and I know they're all going to be nervous. So what are you expecting tonight?
You know what? I'm expecting to just see wonderful dancing and performance. I want them to really enjoy themselves. I want to see lots of rhythm, lots of pizzazz, lots of performance, lots of hip action, lots of head action. I just want them to perform and, most importantly, enjoy themselves. It's a great cause. Tonight is their night. Some of these people have never danced in their life, so they'll get up on that stage, razzle dazzle.
Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks. I've been feeling it since 1966.
So let's go backstage now and see how everyone's getting on. Kira, you're about to go on stage. How are you feeling?
How would you be?
You're nervous.
Yeah, I suppose I am nervous. I'm not a dancer. I'm not a professional dancer. And there's loads of people out there.
There's 700 people out there tonight.
I did not know that.
Now you do. You're going to be fab. So if people missed you during the week in your rehearsals, what are you doing for us tonight? I think it's Sandy in Greece.
So I am, first of all, fulfilling an absolute childhood ambition. I auditioned for the part of Sandy in Greece when I was 15, 16, and I didn't get it. And it's been a sore point my entire life. So I am finally
writing that tonight.
Tonight, that has been put to bed, finally.
It's all for a great cause, and we've seen that throughout the week, and that's what it's all about.
Absolutely. You are a little bit nervous, but dancing with four breast cancer survivors, these four pink ladies here, puts it in perspective. It's not about being the best dancer, and it's not about having the most perfect routine, as you can tell.
Okay, it's come on. We've got to do this before she goes on. Hold on. Georgie, I'm looking at the screen behind us. The show has already started. And how's the nerves?
The nerves, you know, they haven't kicked in yet because we're second last. So I have a bit of time.
Just before Kira, she's last.
Just before Kira. So, yeah, look, it's been a great day. We've had an absolute ball and everyone is just supporting each other. So that's, you know, what I'm kind of focusing on today.
You said to me during the week on the couch when we were chatting to you that you've made great friends and everybody has just been so brilliant to you.
You know, it's been amazing to be around so many survivors. There's so many strong women here. And they've helped me every step of the way. And, you know, we just support each other and get each other through this.
Jake and Karen, the surprise acts here tonight. And everybody went wild.
It was crazy.
So we kept that secret. Yeah, everybody kept that secret.
It was great,
so
yeah.
You did that for Julian and for the whole
cause.
We did, yeah.
I mean, it's for such a great cause. And Julian asked us if we'd do it. And to get the chance to dance again, I think was unreal. I missed Dancing with the Stars since the final. Just literally come off, that's why I'm dripping with sweat. It was roasting in there, but it was great fun. I'm definitely not as fit as I was 3 weeks ago. And I'm absolutely wrecked from doing one dance.
So, Ashing, a great night and a few surprises also.
Absolutely. Well, Julian always has one up his sleeve.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. You know what? It rounded off the evening of fantastic entertainment. Everybody put their heart and souls into the event. And you know what? To round off with Jake and Karen, winners of Dancing with the Stars, how bad?
I mean, and so how important is tonight for you? I know we were talking during the week on Ireland DM, but when you see the atmosphere tonight and people just getting so involved in it.
It's so important. You know what? It's so emotional to see a lot of the survivors getting involved because it means so much to them. They're battling their own demons, battling their own cancer journey. And then they get involved, they dance their hearts out. And what I see is, it's the dedication and commitment has been immense over 9 weeks. And listen, I have to say thank you so much to Ireland AM and TV3 because Kira has been amazing. She danced in Greece, they won, which is fantastic.
Yes, they won.
You know what, you have been amazing support for us because it's about raising funds primarily for research, but it's also about raising awareness.
It is about raising awareness,
it
isn't
is.
It?
It is.
For women.
For young women, because, you know, older women are caught from 50 to 65 with breast check. But it's the younger women, like the Georgies and Emmas and Denise, you know, they're all younger women who are diagnosed unexpectedly. So this is a great awareness journey. And you know what? It's fantastic.
Kira, you won. Congratulations. Yay! Our lip sync champions tonight.
I think what you're looking for us to say is, Awapa Baluba.
Awapa Baluba.
We were
so proud of you and so delighted, and it's such a great cause, and it's just like you said, the Pink Ladies here tonight.
This wasn't about me dancing or Kamal dancing. It was about these three girls dancing and Olivia, who are breast cancer survivors. That's why we're all here, to ensure that there's more people like these fabulous girls in our world and in our lives. I've had an absolute blast, and I've learned a lot doing this dance routine.
But you know what? Literally, can I just sort of say, you were all fantastic. You were all amazing. You're inspirational. And from everyone on Ireland AM, we have to say, a big shout out to our very own Kira! Yay!